If you want to pump your body and expand your mind, there's only one place to go. Mind Pump. Mind Pump. With your hosts, Sal DiStefano, Adam Schaefer, and Justin Andrews.
So we just did an episode where we railed on some supplement companies.
We ran a train.
We actually... We banged them. Well, let's We actually named them.
Well,
list them.
Well, so I mean, this is the preview to what's going to go in this episode. Let them know. We get into the top supplements. We get into C4. We get into pre-gym. We get in. We get into the Nitroflex by Gat. We get into the Dr. Jekyll,
Mr. Hyde
pre-workout. We get into all kinds of. Of the top pre-workouts that are out there.
That crack that you love.
If you're curious to what is in those supplements pre-caged, are you someone that's taking that one? All kinds of different supplements. If you guys are somebody that's taking those supplements, we break down all the different things that are being put into these labels that are what are causing you to feel the way that you feel.
And we're basically, we're explaining why they're a waste of money. Now, if you really want to do something that will enhance your workout, one of the best things you could do statistically is prime your workouts properly. Prime yourself properly based on the way your body moves, based on your imbalances, based on your recruitment patterns, based on the exercises you're about to go do. So it'll make your deadlifts more effective, your squats more effective, your bench press more effective. All of this with simple priming that takes you 5 to 10 minutes before your workout. Now, of course, we have a program that tackles this and teaches you how to program what you do when you prime, and it's called MAPS Prime, and it's available at mindpumpmedia.com. It costs a little bit more than your pre-workout supplement, but you don't have to buy it every single month, and it's not a waste of money. It'll give you way more return on your investment. You'll see more muscle from it, better strength, better recruitment patterns, better movement. It's not a waste. It's MAPS Prime, and it's available at mindpumpmedia.com. Hey, guys. I should ask you, Adam, because you're the allergy expert. Is it crazy right now, or is it just me?
It's really bad. T-Dog's got it, too.
Our parking lot is bad. I stepped out and was sneezing like a mother.
The motherfucker right here comes and blows all that shit around, too. There's nothing. It's crazy. When you have really bad allergies, like, I can see the allergies. I could be inside.
You're like Neo in the Matrix.
Oh, totally. I'm not kidding. I'll be inside and I'll look at my girl.
Yeah. Do you do that cool bendy move to avoid pollen?
What move? What? Oh yeah, no.
You guys know what that is, right? But. Why it gets crazy. So the way plants reproduce is they produce a shit ton.
Yeah, it's sperm.
Are literally getting
semen on.
Yeah, you are getting not semen. That's from humans.
Come all over.
You're getting plant.
It's plant cum.
Yeah, you're getting bukkakeed by a bunch of plants.
Getting pelted with plant cum
all over your face.
Yeah.
So I'm not. I don't normally get allergies, but fuck me, man. Like, it's like
my nose is pregnant,
dude. It feels like the inside of my nose has ants. I'm sneezing all the time, and then I feel like I'm stuck inside of a cloud. Does it make you tired, allergies? Because that's what it's doing to me.
Dude,
my
eyes are watery.
When you have them, and you have them really bad, like someone like me, you have so much more patience for people that do, and you have it's like being sick all the time. It's crazy because
it's fucking annoying.
You just get used to it. Like a lot of times, if it's like really bad allergy season, and I actually do get sick, I'm like confused for like the first day or two of it. Like I'm like, is this a bad cold or is this just really bad allergies right now? I can't even really tell until I start seeing like the mucus that's coming out or whatever. Then I can see the color of it. Then I'm like, oh, fuck, I'm sick or shit.
This is from that random chick.
So different times like will give me different symptoms, right? So if it's grass and that's what's high right now, like then it's like I have itchy eyes, but everything else is fine. If it's like... tree stuff or dust, then I get like an itchy, scratchy throat. And like, so different thing, whatever. Like, so if you, and the news does this like all the time, right? And there's apps that you can have this that tell you like what's high right now as far as allergies. And whichever one it is, I can tell by what my symptoms are. Runny nose, itchy eyes.
Do you get them, Justin?
I do. Well, do? Not as bad as I used to. When I was a kid, I used to get migraines and everything, dude. It was horrible.
Really?
Yeah, especially like the grass shavings, for some reason, that really killed me. I would play soccer and everything, and I would just have these like huge migraines afterwards.
So let me ask you guys this. Do you take... allergy med? I know you have to, right, Adam?
No, I try not to. So I have them in every vehicle and I have them at home. In case. Like my goal is always, like I haven't taken one today, but I did have to take one yesterday. So I'll go through my day as long as I can and not take them until it's like it becomes unbearable.
So here's the thing with allergy medicines. They're all over the counter now, right? And they're promoted as something you take all the time. Mm. Like people's attitudes towards allergy medicines like Claritin or Zyrtec or all the other popular ones is that they're super, super safe for everyday long, long, long term use. Like anytime I talk to someone about allergy medicines, it's like not a big deal to take them all the time. I don't know if you guys knew this or not, but all the popular allergy medicines are starting to be connected to dementia later on in life.
God, another one. You warned me about Prilosec. Well, now I got to...
Well, what they do is they actually interfere with acetylcholine production in the brain. And acetylcholine is a very important neurotransmitter. So one thing that I was thinking is if somebody does take allergy medicines all the time, then they might want to at least supplement with something like choline. Choline is the building block for acetylcholine and theoretically could help your brain's production of acetylcholine. So hopefully it'll mitigate a little bit of the potential long-term damage. And I do understand that you know there's a whole quality of life thing, right? Like if you're just horribly miserable with allergies, just
plagued with it.
Yeah, it's like risk versus reward. Like I'm not enjoying my life. Everything sucks.
This is how I treat it, right? Because that's exactly it. My goal is to not take it. And if I sneeze a couple times or I gotta blow my nose once or twice, I can handle that.
But or you go chop that tree down.
But
man,
some days it gets so bad that it's like nose is running and I got like this hay fever. It's awful. And then to me, it's like okay. There, I'm going to take a supplement. I'm going to take my Zyrtec. And I also rotate them because I also find it very fascinating how quick you become adapted to those.
Well, you know what's funny that's funny you say that. A lot of people say that. I don't know if there's science supporting it yet, but that's anecdotally like across the board.
It makes sense. It makes sense to me.
Well, what's the other thing too is the way that these drugs work is they're not handling the root cause of your allergies, right? What they're doing is they're interrupting the symptom of the cause of your allergy. And the problem with interrupting a symptom of something is that your body has these safeguard mechanisms, and what it will do is it will start to adapt to this, you know, whatever you're doing to interrupt the symptom, and it'll upregulate or downregulate receptors. It'll change production of certain chemicals because now it knows that you're blocking this particular symptom. So an easy example would be like if somebody were to take a hormone like testosterone, your body stops producing its own testosterone because it senses it. Well, if you're taking an allergy medicine, what you'll notice when you stop taking it, so let's say you take one for a year, is you have a rebound effect. Like you go off of them and your allergies at first are way worse than they were before.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then you have to kind of slowly work. So what I did was, because I took Claritin or Zyrtec for probably at least a few years consistently, like every day, consistently every single day.
Oh, wow.
Is I had to go down to a half a dose, and then I stayed on that for a while. Then I went down to half a dose every other day. Then I went on a half a dose every 3 days, and then I went on none. Because when I would go full off, within 3 days, I'd get hives. I'd get like all these symptoms I never had before.
Walk me through a natural process of how your body sort of combats this. Is it produces like histamines to combat or to upregulate that?
So with allergies, you want to be in a state of low inflammation in your body, number one, because inflammation will only increase or enhance the symptom of allergies, right? So, you know, eat healthy, don't eat foods that you're intolerant to.
So you're saying like high inflammatory foods can actually increase like the allergies?
So allergies on their own are inflammatory, right? So when you get sinus allergies, your sinuses get inflamed.
Yeah, I get that.
So reducing being in a low inflammatory state theoretically, and again, I don't think there's any evidence to support this on a scientific level, but anecdotally, lowering, for example, kids with asthma, they'll notice that when you talk to a lot of parents who have kids with asthma, if they like don't have dairy, for example, like, oh, I don't get as much asthma when I don't have as much dairy, or if I eliminate gluten, I don't get, you know, asthma symptoms. This is true for, this could be true for all allergies. So a low inflammatory state would be no foods or little foods that you have intolerances to, good sleep. I think you'll notice when you're in a shitty, real bad sleep and you're real tired, you'll probably get worse allergy symptoms. So basically, be in a state that's low inflammatory.
Well, that makes sense because your body has all these different operating systems, and if you have a bunch of operating systems that are under a ton of stress, and then you're also on top of that allergic and high allergies right now, so that makes sense to keep other operating systems, you know, like suppressed or lower, or not having to run hardcore. So I get that.
And then
that
the other
sense.
Thing is exposure. So the first thing we want to do is avoid allergens completely. You know, like, okay, I'm allergic to the grass outside, so I'm just going to fucking stay inside and put the AC on all the time. And what happens is you actually get worse allergies towards that grass when you do get exposed. Hmm. So you want to expose yourself little by little. There's also evidence.
So you still build a little bit of a hormetic effect, like, so as you adapt to it?
So, for example, children who grow up on farms statistically have far fewer allergies than kids who grow up in urban areas in air-conditioned, you know, clean environments.
Is that also too why, you know, with local honey and local bee honey, like that's a something that
and there's
pursue.
A little bit of, there's some evidence to show that consuming honey produced locally, because the bees of course produce the honey off of pollen that's on the local allergens or whatever, that will also desensitize your body and prevent and help over time reduce allergies. Lastly, you can use natural things to kind of help mitigate the symptoms. For example, if you have lots of sinus inflammation, you could take bromelain on an empty stomach a couple times a day, and you will have reduced reduced systemic inflammation, but definitely in the sinuses. So just a few little tips. And, you know, like, again, it's kind of that, you know, risk versus reward thing. You know, the reward being like, if I'm completely miserable and I can't do my work and I'm just hating life, like, then it's worth it to take this allergy medicine.
Yeah.
But if I can do it without it, then I may be better.
Well, chronic usage is always something to be somewhat, you know, concerned about, always having to take something for something that your body can naturally sort of fight off and produce on its own.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, I mean, I think this brings us right into the topic we want to talk about, right?
Well, I love sharing or being transparent with what's going on behind the scenes with the business. And something that we're going through right now, for all the listeners that care about the business side, is we're restructuring and building the website out. And, you know, this entire time, this business has survived off of just organic growth. People listen to the podcast, and it's full of tons of free information. They go over to our...
They send it to their friend or whatever.
Well, and then you also have the YouTube channel that we've built out, over 250 videos. There's over 25 different playlists on there that we've created. All this, and then you've written all kinds of blogs. We put all kinds of information. So tons of free content. So we've grown pretty well organically, but we really haven't marketed ourselves or tried to advertise at all. And we were really hesitant. And I remember we hired a company last year and ended up firing them. And we finally found somebody who we're excited to work with. And so we're in the process right now of, you know, how do we do that? How do you build these funnels on the internet to drive traffic to people, the podcast, that have never heard who the fuck we are or what we're all about? So we're in the process right now of kind of revisiting some of our early on topics that we used to talk about. And one of the things that gave a lot of traction to Mind Pump was when we started coming out and telling people what pre-workouts were really all about.
Pre-workout supplements.
Yeah, and how much money you could save, because they really are fucking worthless for the most part.
It's funny because a lot of kids right now, you know, and kids for me is anybody under the age of 30, who are working out, have no idea that the pre-workout category of supplements didn't exist until, I don't know, 10, 15 years ago. Before that, there was no category of supplements called pre-workouts. And what supplement companies are very, very smart at, and what they've been smart at, is attaching a supplement to something that people do every day when they go to the gym, which is workout.
Like, and create rituals around what you're already doing.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
It's brilliant,
it
right?
It is brilliant.
It's brilliant. So instead of taking your supplement like whenever, it's like, hey, you're going to work out every day anyway. You're consistent working out. Take this before your workout. So now it becomes a part of your workout. Or take this after your workout. It was brilliant.
Don't you think it's so crazy and strange that how hard it is? Like, so think of all the people that you've coached and trained and you've had this conversation with. I had the hardest time with 20 to 29-year-olds, or lower even, 15 to 29-year-olds that asked this question. And it didn't dawn on to me till literally you just said that right now when you were talking about when this came about. And I'm like, fuck, that's why.
Yeah.
Like,
this is all they know.
Yeah. If you've never, like, pre-workout, not only is pre-workouts the, if you look at like bodybuilding.com, like, and you just Google top 10 supplements, like literally like 5 to 7 of them are pre-workouts. Mm-hmm. So to think that if you're somebody that's younger than 30 years old, you've pretty much grown up with being marketed to that, you know, pre-workout, pre-workout, pre-workout. And so trying to convince those that people that that's not necessary, necessary for you to have a very productive or successful workout or to build muscle or burn fat.
No, and if you read articles online on fitness, like how to work out better, how to get a better bench, how to do whatever, all of them will tie you to, or most of them will tie you to a supplement. And a lot of them, it's pre-workout supplements. So you'll read this article and it'll tell you the best chest workout. And then in the workout itself, I've seen this a million times. They will literally map out your workout, which they spent a grand total of 30 seconds doing. They just said, okay, let's fucking throw some chest exercise up there because programming means nothing to them. But then in there, they'll say 15 minutes before, drink, you know, Super Blast, whatever. And, you know, intra workout, make sure you drink this supplement. And after your workout, you do this. So you're reading this thing like, here's my new workout that I'm going to do today in the gym. And, oh, it says to buy these supplements. And so
to the point that I guarantee you guys are just like me where a majority of people don't ever ask me programming questions. A majority of people ask me, what supplement do I take?
Oh my God, it's crazy.
What supplement do I take? What time do I take it? When's the best? What's the best? Like, that's always what people hit you up with. And I want to just pull what little bit of hair I have left out of my head because I'm like, dude, don't do it. If you only knew how little of a difference this is going to make.
It makes no difference.
And the amount of money that you save, like, they're not fucking cheap, man.
I'm telling you right now, if you were to look at the top selling supplements.
Let's pull it up, Doug. Protein. Show me what are the top supplements?
Well, what I want to do is I want to actually call supplements out and I want to click on them. I want to look at the ingredients.
Oh, wow. We're going to
Fucking clown on them.
Well, let's take the
top
ones.
But before we do that, let's just real quick, little overview. Okay. There's a few reasons why pre-workout, because I know people are thinking, well, if they don't do anything, then why are they so popular? I'll tell you why. Number one,
people are sometimes cheap. Sometimes the majority just means all the fools are on the same side.
Well, yes. And here's the thing. Number one, they've attached it to a ritual, which is exercise. So that's number one. Very, very, very smart and brilliant tool. And marketers have known this for a long time. There's an old saying that during the gold rush, the people who became the rich during the gold rush were the guys that sold the pickaxes and the shovels. It wasn't the guys going to look for gold. Very few people became rich finding gold. It was everybody who supplemented that, right? So what they're doing is they're trying to supplement something that people do when they're into working out, which is working out. So they made that ritual. But number two, they did this very effectively as well, is they put ingredients in this pre-workout that when you take it, you feel fucking amazing. You feel like you're on fire. And you build a very strong tolerance to, and there's an addictive property.
I was going to say, and there's an addictive property to
That's right.
Let's not forget that.
That's right. And it's stimulants.
And you adapt to it really quickly.
Very quickly. And so they're heavy in stimulants. So what happens is if I'm let's say I'm a 20-year-old kid, 20-year-old guy or girl, and I'm really serious about working out, and I'm inundated with all this bullshit information on supplements, and you got to take this pre-workout, helps you build muscle, helps you burn fat, whatever. And I go to a convention and I get a free sample of a fucking pre-workout. And I'm like, you know what? I'm going to try this out. I'm going to see what happens. And the first time I take it, I'm on fucking fire. Like I drink it and the stimulants.
You want to go run laps.
The stimulants hit my system. My brain is just flooded with dopamine and all these, all these neurotransmitters that are making me high as fuck because that's what's happening. I'm super hyper. I have a crazy workout. And remember, most people connect the intensity of the workout to the effectiveness. So now I'm thinking, holy shit, I worked out way harder than I normally do. And I was in the gym for like an hour and a half and I did cardio and I feel so great. I feel so hyped. Now I'm like, I want to buy this amazing product because it feels so good.
Right.
And what happens over time is I take the supplement, it starts to slowly not work. I start to feel shitty and I end up looking for one that's even stronger. And that's what ends up happening. Actually, as a matter of fact, there's forums dedicated to people going off pre-workouts because it's lost its magic is what they'll say, or I need to find a different one. Now, in terms of what it's doing for you, it's not helping you build more muscle. It is not helping you burn more body fat. In fact, it's probably doing the opposite because of all the stimulants.
Well, before you talk about what it's not doing, let's talk about how they can get away with that. Why can they say that this pre-workout helps you burn fat? We'll address that first because the ones that say they can build muscle are different
than
the ones
of the thermogenic effect, bro.
Right, which is what? So you can take the best pre-workout on the market and you can read all the science behind it that supports why it helps you burn fat. I can take that same shit behind a cup of coffee and say the same stuff.
Of course.
Because the idea is that anything that affects your central nervous system like that, that elevates your heart rate, that's thermogenic, like Justin said, is going to speed your heart rate up. If we were to take your day and count how many times your heart beats the entire day, right? Let's just say for hypothetical reasons, it beats 100,000 times. I have no idea if that's even close or not. So 100,000 times it beats. You get on pre-workout, it beats 110,000 times. Those 10,000 more heartbeats throughout the day require more energy, more blood, more calories are having to be expended. Therefore, I can say this supplement can help you burn fat.
You can say that. And we look, fat burning supplements just don't work. If they did, then they would have solved the obesity epidemic. They don't work. What they do is they feel great, but you do build up a tolerance very quickly. In fact, fat burning supplements that pro bodybuilders use that are illegal, like clenbuterol, they work for a very short period of time. They'll take them for a week or two and that's it. Because after that, your body gets adapted. Same thing happens with stimulants. And you know this if you've taken a pre-workout, is you get great fucking workouts for like a week and a half, 2 weeks or whatever, and then they kind of stop. And by the way, great workouts, I put in quotation, because really you're just working out harder, but it's not necessarily better.
You may be adding more damage that you got to recover from.
Yeah, and here's what you need to realize. When I flood my body with stimulants, what I'm doing is I'm putting my body in an artificial fight or flight response. I'm elevating stress chemicals and stress hormones, all of which are detrimental to building muscle. You take lots of stimulants, you do get a spike in cortisol. Now, you keep that up over time. In the short term, cortisol will give you more energy. But in the long term, it starts to burn muscle. And I know, I've known plenty of people I've trained who I've taken them off fat burners or pre-workouts, gotten their body to readjust, their workouts got even better, and they started building muscle again because they were so gacked on this high stress, you know, their body was in this high stress state all the time that it was catabolic.
Yeah.
They were actually burning muscle the entire time. Really, the only ingredient in a pre-workout supplement that'll do anything for you is creatine.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, you can find super cheap online in pure form.
Which, by the way, not all of them have that.
No.
Very few have that. Like, so this is where they really get you. They market you like this: pre-workout, intra-workout, post-workout. So now I'm gonna fucking
are
hit
there
you.
Really intra-workout?
Yes.
Yeah.
Shit.
There are intro. There are intra-workout supplements. There's post-workout supplements, and so this is how it works. You get your all your shit that are stimulants, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's in there. Then you get your intra, which is typically your branch chain, your creatine, those type of stuff, and then your post, which is like a combination of all that stuff except for the stimulants at the end, right? So that's what you're not getting. So they like, and so you get these three, and then you know what ends up happening, right? Is all these companies?
Here's your pharmacy.
The battle and the shit talking that goes back and forth is like, which is pure, which has more of the better things. Like, so like when you talk to guys, I remember
is always better.
I remember like when we had Joe D on the show, and like his whole marketing scheme behind his supplement is like, dude, look at the back of how many grams of like caffeine and shit. Like he has like all the highest. Like if you're not a pre-workout person, then you took his, you will be flying because it's so strong. And so that's their marketing strategy is like, oh, okay, we're going to attack all
these. We're going to make you feel this the most.
Yeah, exactly.
Right,
we're going to make you feel the stimulant more than anybody else. And then we're going to call out all these other supplement companies that, oh, they barely put any of that in there. Oh, this is the most effective piece of the supplement. And they only have 0.5 grams. We have 1.5 grams. And then they'll market it like this. Three times more effective than this. Well, it has three times more of the fucking caffeine, so they can get away by marketing that way.
I was shaking for 3 hours.
But in reality, it's really not that much better.
No, and here's the thing. Like, even something like protein. Like, we know protein is essential for the body, and we know protein is used to build muscle. Does more protein build more muscle? Up to a certain point, not at all. In fact, if we go infinite with that, and I'm like, I'm going to eat 1,000 grams of protein today, I'm going to hurt myself, get sick, not build more muscle. And that's true for almost any ingredient. So if they say, hey, studies show that 150 milligrams of caffeine, you know, improve fat oxidation, improve concentration, people were able to do two more reps based up, you know, to fatigue or whatever, that doesn't mean 500 milligrams of caffeine is better. In fact, 500 milligrams of caffeine for a lot of people will be far worse, will reduce performance mm-hmm. and cause lots of problems. So, you know, that's just the supplement mantra, right? Well, if something works a little bit more, works better, which is never double down. So pre-workouts, and the reason why we're talking about stimulants is because if you eliminate the stimulants out of pre-workouts, nobody would buy them. It's a fact. Like, it's a fact. Like, pre-workout supplements that have no stimulants don't sell shit. They just don't make any money off of them at all.
Because you can't feel them.
You can't feel them. They don't do anything for you. It's all about the stimulants. The most popular ones have a lot of the most powerful stimulants. Now, the way pre-workouts are marketed is like this. They're supposed to give you more energy to work out. That's the stimulants. They're supposed to give your muscles better things for recovery. Those are the random amino acids or the, you know, branched amino acids or whatever they put in there. And they're supposed to improve blood flow, which is supposed to give you a better pump, which is never been proven and has been shown in study after study after study that it does not equate to more muscle. So I think we should break them down. I think we should go on some supplements.
Let's take the top supplement. Let's find the top supplement, the pre-workout.
Let's break down like the top three or something.
Is this it right here?
Where are we sourcing this? This is gym pre-gym.
So we're on bodybuilding.com, which is one of the largest supplement retailers online. In fact, I think bodybuilding.com is one of the largest websites.
Okay, so this is more of a popularity contest right here. Okay.
Yes. So
yeah, what sells the most?
So they ranked they're ranking their top 10. And so the number one ranked pre-workout according to bodybuilding.com is gym pre-gym.
4,136 reviews just on that supplement.
So let's look at the product, Doug, if you don't mind, and let's look at the ingredients of this product.
Yeah, go to that first page you had up, Doug.
So before we look at their where they're trying to sell you
with, wow,
like, how much this and that has. Go down to the actual ingredient. I want to see what the, like, you know,
ooh,
where it shows
cherry,
like
limeade.
Like the other ingredients. Here we go. So first ingredient, dextrose sugar.
Which, let's talk. Okay, hold on. Let's teach people how to read a label a bit. No. I'm serious. Like, a lot of people don't understand that when you read the ingredients, they order them in the of what has the most inside the supplement. A lot of people don't know that. So. And I typically tell people the first three is a majority of, like,
good point.
What is in that. And this goes for all food labels.
That's
so
right.
If you flip a food label around and it says where the ingredients, the order that it is written in is the order of what's most abundant in that supplement.
Right. So first ingredient, dextrose, sugar, natural and artificial flavors.
Is the second highest thing in there. Yeah.
So it's probably sucralose, I would assume.
Red number 57.
Yeah, because sucralose is... Oh, there's sucralose right there. Right after calcium silicate. Calcium silicate, I believe, is in there to keep it from binding, if I'm not mistaken. Sucralose is the very popular artificial sweetener.
Another sweetener.
Which has been shown pretty conclusively to fundamentally alter gut flora. And if you've been listening to Mind Pump, you know how bad of an idea it is to fuck with your gut flora. Everything from health to your cravings to, you know, gaining fat and building muscle is tied to gut flora, and altering that will fuck with all those things. And if you take a pre-workout every single time you work out, you're taking a lot of sucralose. Some more artificial flavors, and then a bunch of artificial coloring, which you got to ask yourself this, okay? If you're listening to this, I can understand why there's artificial flavoring, right? People want to drink something that tastes good. Color? Mm. Like, what the fuck is
that?
Why? Because people like shit to be colored.
Familiarized. Well, let's put it this way. Remember when ketchup came out with, like, green ketchup?
Mm-hmm. Nobody
bought it. Black ketchup?
Yeah.
It's fucking disgusting.
No.
It's this weird, like, perception. Like, we expect things to look a certain
way. Yeah,
and they play into that.
And I want people to be intelligent and be objective. Think of it this way. Think of what is your objective with supplements? What is your desired outcome? Is my desired outcome to drink a tasty, fruity, colorful drink? Mm-hmm. If that's my desired outcome, I will bet you, I'll tell you this right now, there's a million and one different drinks I could take that taste better and have better colors than this supplement.
Well,
right
you know what's interesting? You know why they're super bright colored and like crazy like that? Like, think about the commercials we grew up with, like in
Gatorade
all those,
and stuff like that, where they would do black and white, and then you see like this crazy vibrant orange.
Well, not
or blue.
Only just Gatorade. I'm talking about like sugar cereals and like you know
Kool-Aid and all that.
Everything was like super bright colors.
You do realize that humans naturally are attracted to bright, vibrant colors because in nature that signifies high nutrient content. Mm-hmm. Like if you go in nature and you're walking around and you're hungry and you see a tree with fucking boom fruit all over it that's just vibrant colors or berries or you know roots that have these wonderful colors and you know when I crack an egg from a chicken that's
bright orange yellow
bright orange you know yolk like it means high nutrient content. What they're doing is they're tricking you by putting in some bullshit color, which, by the way, artificial colors now are more and more connected to health problems, including.
And the irony is they serve no purpose in this.
Nothing, just color.
They serve, like, so when we make our, because we make a, I remember we put this on our website way back when, is we used to, you know, tell people, okay, if you won't give up your pre-workout, here's how you make it from the raw ingredients. So at least you're eliminating some of the shit that you don't even need in there, which is all this fake coloring and stuff. So here's the one that I think is crazy. Caffeine, 300 milligrams.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about
one serving.
Okay, a cup of coffee is what, 50 milligrams is a cup of coffee.
No. So a shot of espresso will be about 75 milligrams.
That's a shot of espresso. One cup of coffee is less than an espresso shot.
Per volume, but the fact that you're having this like more volume. So a typical Starbucks 8-ounce cup of coffee will be around 200 milligrams. So they're giving you a pretty strong cup of coffee per serving. How many scoops is per serving there, Doug?
One scoop.
Yeah.
Now, if you
26.5 grams.
Now, if you go to the bottom, does it say take one or two scoops?
It says serving size is one, so it's one.
One scoop.
Yeah, so it's one
scoop.
So 300 milligrams just from the caffeine. So it's basically like taking a venti cup of coffee from Starbucks.
Yeah. Oh, by the way,
before you put the other stimulants.
By
in
the
there.
Way, the red number 40 dye. I knew there was an issue with it because I have a family member who's got lots of allergies and all this kind of stuff. Red 40 number dye has been linked to hyperactivity in kids and has been shown to give some side effect to mice as well, reproductive side effects. So red number 40, very popular food coloring, and it's been connected to some things that aren't so good for you. So I wanted to make sure I said that. Yes, caffeine, 300 milligrams. It's a nice hefty dose of caffeine. That's what you're feeling when you take pre-gym. That's what's making you get all hyped up. But let's look at the other ingredients, right? Because it's going to say, oh, here's all these great things that are going to do. They're going to help you build muscle. So creatine hydrochloride. So 2 grams of creatine. Creatine will help you build muscle. Definitely.
But let's talk even about that. That's such a low dose of it.
it's 2 grams. You typically want to take between
three to five.
Yeah, right? 3 to 5. I can get way more servings of creatine for less money than buying this particular pre-workout. So if you want to take creatine because it does work for most people, I would buy pure creatine
and
monohydrate.
Is it the beta-alanine or the citrulline that gives you the tingly fingers?
So they have beta-alanine in there, which is they call carnosine, which is a brand name of beta-alanine. Beta-alanine will increase histamine under the skin, so you might get a little tingly sensation. Beta-alanine in studies was shown to improve endurance. So endurance athletes will have a little bit more endurance because it buffers lactic acid in muscles. Is the effect large? Not really. Probably you won't be able to tell. In fact, if we eliminated the caffeine and the creatine and you just took everything else, and we'll go over all the other stuff, you're not going to really notice much of a difference at all. So there's beta-alanine. Betaine is in there also. Also, one of those supplements that was shown to reduce certain markers within muscle. Taurine increases certain neurotransmitter production in the brain, theoretically. If we go down the list, you know, citrulline. Here we go. Let's talk about citrulline for a second because that's a main ingredient in a pre-workout. It used to be arginine, but now everybody's using citrulline because citrulline raises arginine levels in the blood more than arginine does because arginine gets destroyed by the liver and the kidneys, whereas citrulline doesn't. So why do you want more arginine in the blood? Because arginine is used to make nitric oxide. Why do you want more nitric oxide? Nitric oxide relaxes blood vessels. So theoretically, it will increase blood flow. Oh, wait a minute. I'm going to get pump needs blood flow. That means if I take this, I'll get a better pump. No.
And the theory
pump behind, your brakes right there.
Well, and the theory behind that and where they will say that supplements build muscle is, okay, I can get more blood flow to my more blood flow to my muscles, more oxygen to my muscles, which means speeding up recovery and more nutrients are getting to the muscles to help build them.
That's right.
So that's how they take that little bit of science, manipulate it to tell you that it builds muscle, increases the pump, and does all these magnificent things that are just supposed
that's
to be
right.
game-changing.
That's right. So exactly what Adam said.
Magic.
Like, oh, wait a minute. Nitric oxide opens blood vessels. Oh, and then they'll start connecting the dots. So the rest of it is them making shit up. Like the first part, citrulline increases arginine in the blood. Correct. Does that mean you get a rise in nitric oxide? Studies will show in people with blood pressure issues and in some cases of erectile dysfunction due to blood pressure that it does. Does this mean it will do it to healthy people? Not necessarily. And then they take it a step further. More nitric oxide means a better pump? No. Actually, there's no science. There's zero studies showing that you get a better quote-unquote pump. And a pump is so subjective. Like, I don't even know how you would fucking study that to begin with.
Right.
You know, what's going to get what's going to give you a better pump? And so many things are connected to having
a pump.
How
do you measure that?
And not only that, but a lot of the reasons why getting a pump leads to more muscle, a lot of it has to do with the environment your body's in that allows you to get a better pump. So you're more hydrated, you have a better diet, you're more recovered, better sleep. So now I get a better pump, but is it the pump that built more muscle or is it the environment that I was in that allowed me to get a pump, better pump? Does that make sense?
Totally.
So, but will the pump itself maybe build more muscle? Perhaps it will, but is that tied to supplements or is it more tied to diet
to
and your workout?
Yeah.
That's the key.
For sure.
So here's the thing that I always ask people when they debate me on pre-workout supplements. Take out the creatine, okay? Because if you give someone creatine who's not taking it, they're going to build more muscle. Take the creatine out. Take a pre-workout, and I want to see the study that shows taking a pre-workout builds more muscle than not. I want to see that study. Guess what? None of them exist.
It doesn't.
Yeah,
of
course
they don't exist.
Yeah.
And they've done studies on it, and they've all shown it doesn't do shit.
No, this is a feel thing. People buy this for the feeling into their workout.
Right. Now, it also, pre-gym also contains the branched chain amino acids. Now, branched chain amino acids demonstrate or show in studies better muscle recovery when people take them who also have a low protein diet. So if you are a vegan athlete and your protein intake is really low, you're eating like 60 grams of protein a day, or you know, you're just eating your essential protein, will supplementing with branched amino acids before your workout help you recover with recovery? Perhaps. Will branched amino acids help you if you're eating adequate protein? Nope.
Which is so ironic because the guy who recommends 3 grams of fucking protein per pound of body weight
also
has a pre-workout that gives you more fucking amino acids inside the pre-workout that you don't fucking need because you're already doing 3 grams of fucking protein.
That's right.
You can never over-protein.
Yeah,
That's right. Doug, can we go to the next? I think we've hammered this particular one even more here.
Adequately.
Well, here you go. Cellucor C4.
Let's see how. I bet it's going to be pretty similar.
It's going to be pretty similar. Of course, by the way, I love that they put vitamin C there because everybody thinks vitamin C is so good for you. Every single one of these supplements will have a lot of vitamin C, mainly because they're using ascorbic acid, I think, as a preservative. So it's almost like we got to throw this in there anyway. Oh, and let's list it.
Hey, you're getting vitamins. here you go, kids.
Okay, so I already see the major difference in this one. So the major difference that this one has, this is going to target my people that just love to break that sweat because it's got niacin in it, right?
Yeah.
So if you've ever taken, try this if you don't believe me.
My skin's hot.
Take 30 to 60 milligrams of niacin by itself and sit in your fucking room and don't move for an hour and watch what happens.
It's a sauna.
You'll start sweating your dick off, not even exercising. So when you take a pre-workout like this that has all this niacin in it, you all of a sudden notice like right away, which you'll start to sweat. You'll sweat earlier and you'll sweat more because you've got this niacin in there.
Mm-hmm.
What else does it have?
Now, this one's got the arginine, the citrulline, it's got the beta-alanine in there. It's got caffeine, of course, but so
creatine, this one's only got 1 gram of creatine.
Yeah, 1.6. Oh, by the way, and I'm not speaking in specifics with either one of these supplements or the ones we're going to cover because we have not taken them to a lab and broken them down. But I will say this, Every single, you know, investigation that goes into supplements, where they take supplements and they test them to see what's in them, every single one comes back bad. Like, I've never seen a report come back and be like, hey, the FDA...
Like, it's FDA actually random, the ingredients it says.
Oh, my God. Like, they'll come out with a report and be like, FDA tested the top 10 selling multivitamins and found not one of them met label what the label said. Some of them had heavy metals in them, and some of them had nothing in them.
Well, wasn't one of the worst offenders, like, it was like a Walgreens chain that they had all these, like...
They're horrible.
There was an article that came out last year where they took the five top-selling protein shakes, and all five of them, none of them met the requirements of what they said were inside them. In fact, all but one were 50% less than what it said it was in.
Yep.
So, and the reason why they can get away with that, so people are going like, how the fuck can
nobody
you
nobody checks them.
Well, yeah, because, okay, supplements, and the irony in this is it's in the grocery store. So you think it's in the grocery store with food, so you assume like, oh, okay, food obviously is regulated and we make sure it's safe and everything. Okay, well, guess what? Supplements are not. Supplements do not have, are not FDA regulated, so they do not have to go through this process of what's in it says it's in it, right? Or what's actually, it says is actually inside of it. So literally, the three of us could put together a supplement in our garage, put together all the, we can order all, and trust me, we've thought about this, ordering all these raw ingredients, putting it in a bottle, slapping our label on it, and sell it. And you know what?
Even worse,
because we want to save money on a scale, we're just going to eyeball it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So you don't have to just and we can get away with it all day. And the worst that's going to happen, okay, we're not going to get sued. We're not going to go out of business. We'll get a letter to fix it. That's it. And it'll be like, oh, my bad. We'll start putting more of that in there. So
there's actual supplement companies that thrive on this, that make supplements and sell them until they're told to stop, and then they go to the next one.
Yeah.
And these are all the gray market ones, and that's the supplement industry is it's a fuck industry. It's a shit fuck industry. It's not good. And again, every report that comes out that tests these products, I've never seen a report come out that'd be like, hey, we tested the top five, whatever. All of them came back accurate. It's always, you know, 7 out of 10 showed all this horrible
way
shit.
Worse offenders versus, like, you know, offenders.
Yeah, like they'll say, like, the best one was at 80% of the label. I'm like, 80%? Like,
I know.
That's still
so bad.
You're missing by, I don't know. I can't imagine if I was hired, you know, as a personal trainer and someone bought 10 sessions for me and I gave them 8. And I'm like, there you go. Like, I'd fucking be out of business in a second. Or
what's the most common filler? Like, they'll just throw in there just to kind of
probably
like
baking,
add in
probably
that.
Baking soda or sugar. Yeah.
Well, the protein powder companies were doing what's called amino acid spiking. So
that.
A cheap way to test a protein powder to see if it has, let's say, 30 grams of protein per serving is they'll test a particular amino acid, and based on that level, then they'll say it's got, you know, this many grams of protein. So what companies were doing is they understood the testing process, and rather than putting 30 grams of protein, they put 15 grams of protein, but they put 30 grams worth of whatever amino acids they were testing.
Right. I would love to develop like a little like test tube lab to sell to people to, like, you know, take their supplement and test and see themselves, you know, like what some of these products really have in them and stuff. It'd be awesome,
bro. We're getting there. The market's actually starting.
I don't think that food scanner.
I think we're gonna see it. I think we're gonna see a lot of it die. I think the more and more people find out how much of it is a gimmick, and I think the consumer is becoming smarter, man. And these companies,
100%.
And you already see, and we called this out 2 years ago. You already see this transition of all these big name companies starting to go to this natural flavor and natural this. Even at the end of the day, natural or not natural, it's still...
Yeah, I mean, it's always going to be there because people just want quick fixes and they want that answer in a pill. Mm-hmm. And
but their market share is shrinking.
Yeah, I was going to say. I don't know. I think we're evolving as humans,
dude,
man.
Dude, it's...
There'll
be more snake oil salesmen in like neuropriming or all these kinds of biohacking type devices.
There you go. Because we're finding more stuff out about biohacking, you know, increasing performance, increasing, you know, things like that, that I see stuff going more that direction. And let's be honest, it's better for you. There's more science supporting that than sucking down some overpriced colored drink.
Well, here's what you do. You look at the whole market of products, and this is how you can kind of see what's happening right now. The supplement market, as big as it is still small compared to like the food market, for example.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look at soft drinks, always strong sellers. Like Coca-Cola is a fucking powerful, it's one of the most powerful brands in the world. And I believe it's the most recognizable brand in the world. Coca-Cola sales and soda sales have been dropping consistently now for like the last 5 years or so. And you can already see Coke start to scramble by creating, you know, flavored with real sugar. And this one has stevia in it. And they're already starting to scramble to figure out, you know, what they're going to do. Cheerios. I looked at Cheerios like, and it says
no gluten free.
I'm like, oh, you guys are... They're trying to stay ahead of what they see is happening.
I mean,
the supplement market is gonna follow.
You know what, Doug? Do pull this up real quick.
Your call with all the
protein
to everything.
Companies owned by Coca-Cola. So I think Coca-Cola is already doing it. I think they're way ahead already.
Oh yeah, you know what they're doing?
Yeah, they'll just buy up. Like, so if you're
hedging their bets.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely. So let's see what they're looking. I'd be interested to see. I don't know. I haven't looked at this in a long time, but Coca-Cola. I mean, when you're that big of a powerhouse. There's no stress. They're not worried.
No,
if the market shifts,
move the money.
Yeah,
in that
just,
direction.
If the market shifts, I've already got our green Coke to handle all the natural sweeteners like real cane sugar.
Oh, I'm sure they bought companies Odwalla.
Yeah, they own Dasani. They own a lot of these companies. People don't realize that. So they're already on. They're already watched. Let's see what the companies are. I guarantee they're already heading in the health direction. It just hedges their bets.
Let's see. Product description.
Did you Google, Doug, what products do...
Well, they own a bunch of soda companies. Then they own Dasani Water. They own, of course, Vitamin Water, which is... By the way, they had a huge lawsuit.
Vitamin Water.
There was a huge lawsuit against Vitamin Water because they were advertising healthy.
Smart Water.
Fuse Tea, Honest Tea, Odwalla.
Oh, well, Odwalla and Honest Tea. There's some of your health ones right there, right?
Yep. So, Nestle is another one. There's these huge companies that, you know, buy all these organic kind of healthy brands because they're hedging their bets. So, yeah. Let's keep breaking down the supplements a little bit. Oh, wait, look at that list. Holy shit.
Those are all the companies they own?
Yeah, it would be just too many to talk about.
Holy shit, that many?
Yeah, it's too many to talk about. I mean, that's just the letter. That's categorized by letter.
Holy shit.
That's how many categories. That's how many
Coca-Cola owns that many companies?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. Doug, let's
talk about having a monopoly on the drink world, dude.
Yeah. That's crazy. Let's go back to the supplements because I'm not done. I want to finish off on the C4. And then we'll look at the next one there. So one more thing about the C4 supplement, and you'll see a lot of these in your pre-workouts, is there's a proprietary blend. So C4 has an explosive energy blend consisting of N-acetyltyrosine, caffeine, which then they list the amount of caffeine, which is 150 milligrams, velvet bean, which is something that's supposed to increase, L-DOPA, I guess, in the blood. Theanine, which is good to combine with caffeine. We actually don't know how much of each of those things is in there because it's a blend. And in reality, that's, of course, the stimulants is what you're feeling in
the
supplement.
That's the secret sauce.
So that's another pre-workout that's a waste of money. Let's go back and look at, what comes next on the list and start to break them down. So we had pre-gym C4. And then we have caged muscle, pre-caged.
Isn't that what's his face?
Caged muscle.
I don't know who that is.
Yeah, that's a tattooed big old buff dude.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Well, Chris Gethin?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Cool. So let's again go down to the ingredients, all the way to the ingredient part.
Yeah, there he is.
Oh my God. Other ingredients. Well, beetroot powder, they're using that for color. Sunflower lecithin, citric acid.
Which can we say just that's a lesser evil?
It says stevia and sucralose.
And he's using the beetroot powder for color versus, red dyes or something like that. So
here's an example of a supplement company or product trying to attract the slightly informed consumer. And what I mean by that is you've heard once or twice that stevia is a better sweetener than sucralose or aspartame, right? So you buy this, you look at the ingredients, you quickly see stevia, you're like, boom, I'm buying this.
Yeah.
Not realizing that the ingredient right afterwards is also sucralose. So they've just added stevia and mixed it with sucralose to give you this is kind of the same product.
Scroll back up.
Let me see what else is in here.
Let me see, go to the top.
There's a whole bunch of shit
right there. What is that? What is that?
It's their ORAC blend, which is a bunch of antioxidants in there. So it's just a bunch of extracts of fruit. 100 milligrams, basically nothing. Basically a little drop or squirt of each of these things.
It's so funny because when you look at a list like that, like if we were to count, right, each thing that's listed in here, just by glance, I'm going to guess probably 60 plus. So if that's got 60 plus things inside of it and it fits in this little tiny fucking scoop this big, yeah. Just like, dude, think about that for a second. Like, how much are you really getting? Like, you're getting like a booger's worth of fucking of all that stuff at best, you know?
Yeah.
How much is it? What's the average cost of these supplements, Doug?
$25 to $50 would be my guess.
No, 50. It's more than that, dude.
More than 50?
Oh, well, it's more than 25, that's for sure.
Never mind.
I don't think it's 50, but 25 would be a cheap.
Well, aren't we on the order page here? Yeah, right there. $35.98.
So this is so it's $36. So you're probably looking at between $36 to $40, right? So you figure this has 20 servings, so it'll last you maybe about a month. People are spending, you know, $30 to $50 a month.
Pre-workout primer, huh?
Yeah, you like that? They threw that fucking.
I see that.
I see that word, everywhere now.
So you're spending $35 to $50 a month, which is. You know what's funny? The irony is that's more than most people are spending for their gym membership.
Right.
Yeah.
You figure it right?
They'll complain if it's more than $10.
Yeah. Okay. I don't want to spend $60 a month on a membership.
Now he's got 6.5 grams of citrulline versus the other ones that were at like
three.
So yeah. He's got double the citrulline. He's got niacin in there. He's got the same amount of niacin as C4. So he likes to sweat his dick off too. He's
who
got,
doesn't?
Right. Where else? Where's the caffeine? I can't see the caffeine. Does that say
274?
Does that
milligrams.
Say? I love this. Does that say neurofocus matrix?
Yeah.
That fucking sounds fucking awesome.
Oh man.
You know what they're grabbing onto? The whole trend of nootropics.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because now you're not like hyper energy, like neurofocus.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Sounds so sciencey and awesome.
Sounds so. And by the way, the caffeine they make sure to put is from green coffee beans.
From
that
green?
makes it better.
So does that say 274 milligrams?
That's what's his name.
So a little
Dr.
less,
Oz?
A little less caffeine, a little more citrulline, and the exact same amount of niacin as C4.
Same waste of money. Yeah, I mean, figure you're spending $40-$50 a month on this. Then you add your protein powder, which God, is probably another $50 a month, right?
The amino acids are extremely low. All okay, total 3.5. Muscle, God, look at the names. Anabolic activator.
Yeah. Ooh. Leucine.
Leucine.
Oh, I need an anabolic activator.
Yeah, no.
So build some muscle. What would you say? I like to give people analogies too. Sal, could you, maybe Doug can figure this out, is I would like to see what a 12-ounce or an 8-ounce steak provides. Like how much?
Oh, amino acids?
Yeah, how much amino acids are in a? I would guess a steak would probably be one of the best places, right, to get all these covered. Or an egg?
I'm gonna do one egg.
Yeah, as you say, let's do an egg. Let's one egg. You need more than one.
No, I want to show you something here. Just want
to
see.
Let's say at breakfast is 4 to 6 eggs. I think you need to do more than one egg,
bro. You would be surprised how many amino acids are in.
One
you know, yeah.
I think that's where this can get really convoluted for a lot of people. So they'll be reading this and they'll be like, well, it's got a muscle activator. It's got the neurotransmitter going on here. It's got the anabolic enhancer and it's giving me energy. Like, you know, guys, it's worth my $36.
Okay, you ready for this? A 3-ounce serving of meat will give you
3 ounces.
That's fucking nothing. Is about 1.5 grams of leucine in just a 3-ounce. Piece of meat.
Okay, so so nobody eats 3 ounces of meat.
Here's another one.
Okay, no, wait, stay right there if we confuse everybody, okay? This has the anabolic activator in this is leucine. It has 3 grams of that. 6 ounces of steak gets all of that.
All of that.
Yes.
Kills it.
Okay.
Here's an even better one. 1 cup of vegetarian baked beans has about 1 gram of each of the branched amino acids.
Whoa.
Yeah, so eat some baked beans. Eat 2 cups of baked beans, man.
So steak and beans, it's a wrap, dude. Steak and beans, you already doubled up on all the anabolic activators that are in here. Mm-hmm. Wow. Mm-hmm. You just took care of that whole category. Let's take care of another category.
I'm
going to
steal that word. I already got ideas.
Let's take care of another category here. So, well, we can take coffee. We'll take care of the Endura Burn. What's that say?
Endura Burn matrix
is pretty much. Let's see here how much is in there. Caffeine. Okay, that's pretty much covered. By the way, too, which the steak we didn't cover, a 6-ounce steak has, I think, close to 3 grams of creatine in it, too.
Yep, I think you're right.
So that the steak would also cover the, what's that under? Is that Pro Pump? What's that under?
Patented.
Creatine HCL.
What's
the fuck is patented
1.5 grams.
Patented. So they put creatine under the.
Can they say that if it isn't patented?
It must be so, like they must have added something to. I don't know what the fuck this.
I don't know if you can say that.
Sure, you can. The blend of it. You can put it with something
patent
else.
Patent it, but
sure.
You actually have to file and patent it.
Well,
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. That's a good question. Get your lawyer after it.
I will.
Well, let's
coming catch after you, man.
Dick. No, we're not. No. We're not the point of this. So, like, by the way, we're not like we had no idea.
We're not haters or nothing.
We had no idea that our favorite guy would be the number one on here. That just happened to be that Jim.
No, you can go to bodybuilding.com and see yourself.
We will put the link in the thing. This is the top 10 pre-workouts, and we're just literally going, this is 1, 2, and 3 right now. So I've got nothing personal against any of these guys.
So here's what I want to do. I want to leave the listeners with some like constructive, like what they can do. Okay. So
that's what I was doing with the whole steak concept.
Oh, there you go.
That's what I was trying to give. I'm trying to give people an idea of where this is naturally found in foods. And so, you know, if you're a vegan, I can see some of these type of things, right? Like, because you miss a lot of the steak, right? And you're not getting a lot of or meats in general that are going to have a lot of these amino acids. Because probably the most valuable things in here, I would argue to say, is the creatine and amino acids.
Well, it's
right?
Not just that. Like, you're right about that. Because I think, like, creatine, for example, the greatest benefit is for vegans. In fact, vegans get they actually get a brain boost from taking creatine. And it's mainly because they have such low creatine levels because they don't eat meat. So, you know.
But steak, eggs, and an orange ought to handle all the top 10 pre-workouts and some. Literally.
Yeah.
Have a steak, an orange, and some baked beans. And what else am I missing on their salad?
Coffee.
There you go. And wash it out. So your breakfast. So for breakfast.
Oh, have breakfast.
Have some steak and eggs and some beans with a cup of coffee, and you pretty much shit on every pre-workout that's in the industry. So
especially if you have it in the morning and you do your workout and later in the day.
It tastes fucking great, right? I'd much rather have that for a meal.
Well, look here. If you want to have a great workout, first of all, don't spend $40 on your monthly pre-workout. That's a waste of money. Take that money and invest it in something that's actually going to do something for you. If you're trying to get in shape, invest it in education. Invest it in, you know, maybe save up your money for a few months and hire a trainer for a session. You know, invest in good programming. You know, maybe spend more. How about this? Instead of spending, $30 a month on your gym and $40 a month on your supplement, maybe take $70 a month and go to a better gym.
Right.
Like, that's going to give you way more benefit than the supplement. If you want to get hyped before your workout, drink a cup of coffee. If you don't like coffee, you can buy
caffeine
pills for dirt cheap, like 200 milligrams a pill, 90 pills. You could probably buy it for under $10.
Yeah, they're cheap.
Way cheap. And then prime your workouts properly, like go into the gym and do some actual priming.
Yeah, do actual priming techniques and, even work on your breathing and get like good and oxygenated before you even start the workout, and hydration, do these like simple things to, you're going to get the immediate energy boost just from doing that alone.
I'll give you this challenge right here. Take your pre-workout supplement, stop taking it for like 3 months. If you want to take creatine, keep taking creatine, but just stop taking your pre-workout, track your workouts, look at your progress, look at how things are going. If you want a stimulant, just drink some coffee.
You don't even need creatine.
And you will not notice a thing.
If you're eating enough steak and eggs and beans and shit, like I said, if that's in your diet pretty regularly, then you don't even need creatine. Skip on that. Doug, can you go back to, I want to see all 10 supplements that happen to be up there. Just out of curiosity, we don't need to go through all 10 and pick them apart, but I'm just interested to see what.
CellulCore has another one at 4.
Be a long
so,
episode.
What is the difference between C450X?
Now 50% more explosive. I think it's probably just got more caffeine in it.
Explosive.
Evolution Nutrition, Shred. There's another one by them called Engine. Then there's Mr. Hyde.
Dr. Jekyll Messiah.
Click on that Mr. Hyde one for me. A lot of people talk about how that one's got that one will make your fucking that'll make you see sounds.
So this is a company that had a big I think it was a big lawsuit over this.
Holy
one.
Shit.
What?
One serving has 300 milligrams of caffeine, regular caffeine, 300 milligrams of caffeine malate. So 369, and then 50 of three different types of caffeine. So you're actually getting a grand total of over 400 milligrams of caffeine. On top of that, They also have Yohimbe in there, which Yohimbe is another central nervous system stimulant. No, you take this shit and you're going to be, I mean, if you're sensitive to stimulants, you're fucked.
Well, so let's talk. Okay, this is what happens. This is what the consumer, like when you hear people in the locker room talking like, hey, bro, what are you taking? Oh, I'm taking, oh, what are you taking? Oh, bro, you got to try this.
I remember when I was like, doing C4. Now I'm doing animal ass fuck.
Right, so that, what is going on?
Man.
That got escalated real quick.
What's going on there is the major difference between their pre-workouts is just the amount of fuck. So seriously, if you want that feeling to be just ramped up, go spend $9 on caffeine pills and be careful. Start off with one, but start to work your way up a half a pill at a time until you fucking shit on the way you feel from that. You'll be twice as wired. If that's what you're chasing, if you're chasing this, I want to be so amped, my hands are shaking, my eyeballs are sweating, and my forehead's red. Like, if that is what you're chasing, you can pretty much achieve all of that through niacin and through caffeine, caffeine pills, which you can get for dirt
cheap. Really, if you're really, really, really tied to pre-workouts, and you're like, no, I love them, I want to take them. All you got, okay, fine, do this. Buy citrulline powder. Buy branched-chain amino acid powder. Buy caffeine and take those, and you're pretty much set. If you want to throw in some beta-alanine, you could do that too. You've made your own, and you've probably spent a quarter of the money that you would normally spend.
That'll cost you. So I've done this before,
and
right?
It'll taste like shit.
It'll cost you on Amazon. It'll cost you. So what we should do? We'll do links, okay? If you want to make your homemade, no crap, no fake shit, like I want to be able to control how fucking crazy strong it is, we'll show you how to make that. I'll give you links on Amazon so you can go straight to that. I think it cost me about $150 for all the raw ingredients, but that shit lasted me like 6 months worth of pre-workouts. So it's going to taste like crap. It tastes kind of, it's like lemon water is what it ends up tasting like.
That's the citrulline that you're tasting.
Yeah, exactly. You taste the citrulline is the only thing you really taste. It's the only thing that has any sort of flavor. All the other stuff is completely raw. So when you mix the citrulline with the creatine, with the branch, with all those things, and the caffeine and the water.
And not only that, but if you make it yourself, you're also taking like stronger doses of things that you should probably want to take stronger doses of. And because the funny thing is, if you actually matched the doses that are in these supplements, it probably would have lasted you 2 years.
Oh, yeah.
Instead of 6 months.
Oh, yeah. What I did, yeah. I ramped up the citrulline and I ramped up the caffeine and creatine, and then all the other stuff I didn't worry about because it's very.
Now, let me ask you this, Adam. Do you take anything pre-workout?
No, I don't take anything.
I haven't taken anything pre-workout.
I actually still have those bottles that we're talking about on my refrigerator. They've been there for about two and a half years now. So, but I mean, there's going to be people that, you know what, they feel like, here's where I get it. Maybe you're not a coffee drinker and you get up really early in the morning and this is, you take it because you absolutely need to be woken up we're not going to get you to stop doing that. That's okay. So, you know, but hey, let's save some money. Let's do this the smarter way. And it will let me tell you what is making you sweat, what is giving you that crazy energy. And I'm telling you right now, it's the caffeine. The sweating part is the niacin. And you can buy that by itself and you can control your dose. So if it's not, you can start with a 200 milligram dose. If that's not enough for you and you go to 400, I guarantee that'd probably be enough for most people.
Yeah. Now, what I would like to see is these supplement companies have a lot of money, right? They got tons of money. Why don't they take an independent, research company and actually do a double blind placebo controlled study?
Some of them do that.
And show not improve performance right away, because all stimulants would do that. If you take someone who's never taken a stimulant and I give them one, they're going to have improved performance. That's easy. Take that out. Take the stimulants out. Take out the creatine. We know those things, what they do. Give them everything else. And let's see at the end of 3 months if they've built more muscle and burned more body fat, all things being equal. You know why they won't do it? Because they know it'll happen. The study will come back and it'll show that it's fucking bullshit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That there was no real benefit, no more muscle, no more fat loss. They lost weight in their wallet, and that's about it.
Yeah.
So my advice, throw that shit away or sell it on Craigslist to somebody. Use bottle of Mr. Hyde or sell your pre-gym.
Don't do that to your bro.
Let's go back to the main list. I want to see all of them again, Doug. C4, we saw the Cellucor did they're stronger, the Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde stuff or whatever.
Keep going down. You have GAT, GAT, Nitroflex. Then there's MuscleTech. What's old MuscleTech?
Is the NitroFlex may be the first actual, like, not focused heavily on the caffeine, and maybe this will be more towards the nitric oxide and that. What does it say? It says helps promote energy, strength, testosterone, and reduce feelings of fatigue.
I will bet you $100 that there's hella stimulants in that.
Yeah.
Guaranteed it's not.
Well, of course, it says promotes energy.
Not only that, it's a top seller. It's not going to sell anything if they don't have a stimulants in there.
The main reason why it's
I want to see the testosterone boosting supplements. I don't see anything that could... Oh, wait. Clinically studied testosterone enhancing complex.
Wow, this company still gets away with the proprietary blend bullshit.
I've never even heard of CFB, right. And there's a U.S. patent on it. Better look that up.
Can I see who it's attached? This must be attached to a big name because...
Well, no, GAT is the name of the company.
Yeah.
I forgot what it stands for.
John Jones was part of that for a while. GAT Nutrition.
Big Rami.
Yeah.
It's cheaper too, so it's $29.
Yeah, testosterone boosters. By the way, do they raise testosterone? Some of them do, and in people who have low testosterone. And people with healthy testosterone, there's really nothing that raises testosterone.
How about this? Okay, this is really even shadier. They do this NitroFlex proprietary blend, and it has all the things the other supplements have, but it doesn't list how many milligrams of each are in it. Which that's a huge fucking red flag right there. But what they're smart enough to do is they list by themselves the 3 grams of citrulline, 1.5 of beta, and then arginine, 1.5, so they can
say that they have those at least.
Yeah, I don't see where's the caffeine at.
Yeah, that's a classic trick that supplement companies will do with their blends is they can say something's in there if they put a little bit of in there. So they'll what's called pixie dusting. They'll put a tiny amount of each of these things. And if you're reading the bodybuilding magazines and you read about all these ingredients, next thing you know, you look at the supplement, you're like, oh, this one has everything in it. It's got to be the best one.
A lot like crop dusting.
It's basically like crop dusting.
Oh, clinically. What does that say at the very bottom? The clinically suited testosterone enhancing complex.
Studied.
Oh my God! Clinically studied testosterone enhancing. You don't even get the name of it.
Is that what they're doing? Is they're listing that, or is that something totally different?
That's something totally different.
The guy had a lab coat and everything.
They're not even telling you what it is. It just says clinically studied testosterone enhancing complex. You know what that means? They could literally have a 0.001 of
What the hell is it?
Okay, of horny goat weed, and they can claim that. If you've got 0.0001 of horny goat weed in that supplement, you could say these words instead: clinically studied testosterone enhancing complex, and that sounds way cooler.
Mm. Yeah, it's the complex.
Yeah, very.
That's what got me.
Yeah, very, very interesting. Anyway, that's the bottom line, right? I tell you what, save your money, spend it on your gym or some education. Hell, get MAPS Prime. That'll blow you the fuck away. You don't have to buy it every month, by the way. You just get it once and you're set. I mean, I don't know. Any other advice you could give these guys?
Go. Oh, wow. Cellucor has 3.
I don't know. I'm tired of looking at it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know what?
I know they're popular.
Exactly. I mean, we hadn't talked about it's been, and I know if you've been a listener since day one, you listen to all 500 episodes, I apologize because we have ranted on supplements before at least more than once, but it's actually been a while since we talked about this. I felt like this was a good topic. We were in the middle of, you know, those that enjoy the business side, like we're right in the middle of, you know, we're going to market towards these people. So our goal right now is we're gonna go after all the market, which is we had to wait till we were at this point where we could actually hire a company to handle this first because that's a monster. These guys, most of these companies are multi-million dollar companies that have a whole department around marketing to people, and we are now gonna try and counter that. So we had to build a little bit of muscle, man. We had to get some staff and some people
a little bit.
before we could start punking some of these people. We needed to staff up a bit, get a crew, and hire a company to help us out with that. So we are in the middle of doing that. So look forward to coming after these motherfuckers.
Beautiful. Look, if you go to mindpumpmedia.com, we still have 30 days of coaching for free. In fact, I think we cover supplements in one of those days as well. So you get great information. It's absolutely free. You just go to the site and you opt in. Also, if you ever have any questions you want to ask us individually, or if you just want to look at the content that we all put out individually, you got to check out our Instagram pages. My page is Mind Pump Sal. Adam is Mind Pump Adam. Justin's Mind Pump Justin. And the Mind Pump page is Mind Pump Media.
Thank you for listening to Mind Pump. If your goal is to build and shape your body, dramatically improve your health and energy, and maximize your overall performance, check out our discounted RGB Super Bundle at mindpumpmedia.com. The RGB Super Bundle includes MAPS Anabolic, MAPS Performance, and MAPS Aesthetic, 9 months of phased expert exercise programming designed by Sal, Adam, and Justin to systematically transform the way your body looks, feels, and performs. With detailed workout blueprints and over 200 videos, the RGB Super Bundle is like having Sal, Adam, and Justin as your own personal trainers, but at a fraction of the price. The RGB Super Bundle has a full 30-day money-back guarantee, and you can get it now plus other valuable free resources at mindpumpmedia.com. If you enjoy this show, please share the love by leaving us a 5-star rating and review on iTunes and by introducing Mind Pump to your friends and family. We thank you for your support, and until next time, this is Mind Pump.